All right, with this forecast video update on this Tuesday, February the 11th, this is the evening edition. I am Josh Brown. Well, I hope that everyone had a wonderful Tuesday. And yes, it's been another warm day here across Central Florida like it was yesterday. And that will continue as we head into the next couple of days before our next system brings our chance for showers, which won't be until Valentine's Day ahead of a cold front, which will help cool down our temperatures by the time we get into the President's Day holiday weekend, which I'll explain more about that here in just a little bit. But let's take a look at the high temperatures that Central Florida did reach earlier this afternoon, since it's been another warm day. And as you can see, that yes, we did hit 80s for pretty much almost all of us here across the entire viewing area. But not everybody didn't see 80s today, like places like Titusville and Sanford. These areas did not hit 80 or above earlier this afternoon. Mostly these areas stayed in the upper 70s. So it was 79 degrees earlier today, but here in Orlando, we actually did hit 85 degrees today, so we were in the mid-80s earlier this afternoon. It was 84 today in Kissimmee, it was 85 down in Lakeland, it was 84 this afternoon in the Villages area. Ocala, the same thing for you, the high temperature was 84 today, and then we had low 80s up here just to the north and east of Orlando, places like Daytona Beach and Palm Coast. You can see these areas did hit a high temperature this afternoon. At about 83 degrees. So let's go ahead and take a look at our current temperatures right now across Central Florida at this 8 o'clock hour. And as you can see, we're mostly in the 70s right now as of this hour, as you can see. So right now here in Orlando, still pretty warm out there right now, but at least it's not as warm like it was earlier today. We got 79 right now as the current temperature here in town. We got 78 right now in Kissimmee. We got 75 in Sanford. Same story for you guys up in the Villages. And Titusville as well. We got 73 in Ocala, and we got 71 right now in the Palm Coast area. We got 78 in Daytona Beach, and we got 76 in the Lakeland area. So yeah, still kind of warm out there as of this evening, but not as super warm like it was earlier this afternoon. So just keep that in mind. So if you have any outdoor plans for the rest of this evening, whether if you're going to go see the fireworks, we'll say for example at the Disney theme parks, or if you're going to go out to dinner or out to a movie, or any after-school-related events that may be going on this evening as well, you should be fine. Again, still not looking too bad out there, but once you step outside, you may still feel a little bit of humidity out there, but at least it's not as humid like it was, like I said, earlier this afternoon. So just keep that in mind. And speaking of humidity and warm temperatures, let's take a look here at what's going to be happening as far as warm conditions go on Futurecast, and of course for temperatures we're expecting as we head into both the Wednesday and Thursday. So just give me just a second here. And remember, guys, if you're just coming on into the Facebook live stream on this Tuesday night, remember, don't forget to go ahead and share this live feed to your other Facebook followers, because you know my motto, sharing is caring. So just note that. All right, so as we get into the rest of this evening, we'll see temperatures continue to stay in mostly in the 70s for almost everybody here in Central Florida, but it looks like over the next couple of hours, we'll see temperatures basically north and west of Orlando get down into the upper 60s. Still a little cool, could get a little cooler, but still going to be really, still going to be kind of warm out there as we head into the rest of this evening. But as we head into the overnight hours and as we start the day on your Wednesday morning, stop the clock here for 7 o'clock in the morning. We'll see morning low temperatures get down into the mid to upper 60s to about 70 here in Central Florida, like right here in Titusville, excuse me. You may see a morning low temperature tomorrow morning at about 70 for you. 68 will be the morning low temperature tomorrow morning in Orlando, 65 for the low in Sanford, 64 for Daytona Beach, 61 for Palm Coast. 63 will be the morning low temperature tomorrow morning in Ocala. 64 for the Villages will be around 66 in Kissimmee, and 67 will be the low if you live down in Lakeland as we head into early tomorrow morning. So not too bad of a start, but like I said, once you step outside early tomorrow morning, whether you're going to go out maybe for an early morning run before you start the day, it's going to be feeling a little humid out there, but at least it'll be still a bit cooler. So just keep that in mind. But as we do get into Wednesday afternoon, since we'll be seeing another dry day in Central Florida, here we go again. We'll see temperatures again get up into the low to mid 80s here across Central Florida. So if you're expecting to be heading out to, either to the beach or heading out to the attractions all day tomorrow, just be sure that you grab some sunscreen, because once you step outside, especially in the sunshine, That's what's going to be happening because, you know, you do not want to get yourself sunburned if you're going to be out all day. So just keep that in mind. So, but just saying there. But yes, it'll be definitely another warm day here across Central Florida. Like, for example, we could see a high temperature tomorrow, excuse me, at about 85 in Orlando. Same thing for Sanford, could see a high temperature tomorrow at about 85 as well down in Kissimmee, 84 for the Villages. Same thing for Ocala. Also, Lakeland could see a high temperature tomorrow at 84 degrees. Could see a little bit cooler temperatures here once you go towards down 95. It's still kind of warm out there, but still pretty good beach days, or a beach day rather, as we head into your Wednesdays. We're talking about a high at about 80 for Titusville, 81 for Daytona Beach, and 77 for the high temperature tomorrow and the Palm Coast area. So there you go. So yes, another warm day again is going to be happening once we head into your Wednesday across Central Florida. So just note that. And then as we head into tomorrow night, we'll see temperatures continue to stay in the 70s, especially during the evening. So not too bad to be outdoors, especially after the sun goes down. But again, once you step outside, it could feel a little humid. But it shouldn't be too bad as far as outdoor plants go. So just keep that in mind. But as we look at the lows, though, for early Thursday morning, we'll start the day that morning into the upper 60s, especially west of Orlando. So places like Ocala can see a morning low temperature at about 68 on Thursday. Same thing for the Villages. 69 will be the low on Thursday morning for both cities like Lakeland and Palm Coast. And then the rest of our viewing area, including Orlando, will see temperatures basically staying in the lower 70s. So, yes, it'll be a very, at least another warm morning. Right here in the viewing area. So just keep that in mind there. And then as we head into the afternoon, we do this again here, but this is Thursday though I'm talking about. We're talking about temperatures again, another day with low to even middle 80s across the entire viewing area. So we're talking about a high temperature in Orlando at about 84 on Thursday. Same thing for Sanford. Same story for you guys in Titusville and Daytona Beach. We're talking about a high on Thursday at about 82 in Palm Coast. Same thing for you guys in Ocala, 83 for Kissimmee, 81 for the high temperature Thursday in the Villages, and also for Lakeland. So Thursday should be the last day that we'll see temperatures in the 80s if you're not a big fan of that, because like I said before just a few minutes ago, we'll be tracking our next system that'll bring us our next chance for showers ahead of a cold front, which we'll see that on the GFS here in just a few minutes. So just hang tight for that. But as we continue the clock here all the way to the overnight hours, late Thursday night and early Friday, it looks like the front may approach Central Florida, maybe we'll say early Friday, but ahead of that, we'll still see temperatures kind of warm and mild here, basically from Sanford to Orlando and Kissimmee, Titusville, Lakeland into the low 70s, but behind the front, temperatures will start to cool down into the 60s, basically for places like Ocala, the Villages, Daytona Beach, and Palm Coast. So there you have it. All right, so let's get a check of the radar before we get to the GFS, because we didn't get a chance to see that here, just, especially in the beginning of this video. So let's get a check of that right now. And as you can see, we are looking pretty dry for almost all of us here across Central Florida, but I cannot rule out maybe a couple of isolated, maybe one or two showers for some spots overnight tonight, especially in the coastal areas, but there are a couple of brief showers right here in northeastern Lake County, just east of Paisley, some right here down around near Apopka, and also down towards Kissimmee into the Lake Kissimmee area. But it's nothing too major to worry about. Like I said, the rest of us should be looking dry as we head into the rest of tonight and, of course, for the next couple of days. So, just saying. All right, so let's get to Friday's forecast here, at least during the afternoon part. And by the way, I do want to mention that Friday is Valentine's Day. So just don't forget about that. And if you're expecting to be outdoors all day on Valentine's Day on Friday, like I said before a few times, like earlier in this feed, and of course from last night, that there'll be some rain in the forecast, but it will not be an all-day rainmaker. Not talking about like an all-day washout, but just want to let you know there could be some on and off pop-up isolated to even a few scattered showers as we head into Valentine's Day. So just keep that in mind. And again, that's going to be ahead and behind a cold front that will be moving through. That's going to help temperatures cool down and get a little break from the 80s for a while. So just keep that in mind. But you still may want to have the poncho handy, though, if you're going to be outdoors all day with your sweethearts on Valentine's Day, whether if you're going to the beach or maybe going to the attractions or going out to a brunch or maybe a dinner. So just keep that in mind. But like I said before, just a minute ago, it will not be a total washout all day. So just keep that in mind. But here's a look at the high temperatures, though, we're expecting on Valentine's Day, though. So once the front does pass through, we'll see temperatures cool off into the mostly in the low to mid 70s, we're going to call as we head into that day. It'll still be kind of a little warm, but at least it will not be as warm like we're going to be seeing tomorrow and again on Thursday, or like we've seen today or yesterday. So just keep that in mind. But after we deal with the rain on Friday, as we get into the first half of the President's Day holiday weekend, so we're gonna go over to Saturday here. The rain should be moving out of here, at least for almost all of us, as we head into the day on Saturday. So at least we'll be dry. But again, just want to mention that if you live south of Orlando, that there could be a few isolated leftover spottier showers, especially during the afternoon. But it's not going to be an all-day rain event, and the rain coverage will be lower. So just keep that in mind. But otherwise, it'll be mostly sunny as we head into the first half of the holiday weekend. And again, it's President's Day I'm talking about. So you should be okay for outdoor plans if you do have some, or if you plan on going out to maybe a late Valentine's date or something. If you didn't get, or if you're not going to on Friday, then same thing, you'll be good to go as we head into what that day. But look at those high temperatures, though, we're expecting the day after Valentine's Day. As we get into the first half of the President's Day holiday weekend, we're expecting these temperatures to get down a little bit cooler, so looking nice with highs in the upper 60s into the lower 70s. So if you're a big fan of these slightly cooler temperatures, then I think you're going to like the outdoor weather as we head into that day. So perfect outdoor plans, at least for at least weather related, as we head into that day. So please do get out and enjoy that if you can. All right, now let's get into the second half of the holiday weekend, which is on Sunday, February the 16th here. We're expecting pretty much almost more of the same like we're going to see on Saturday, just a few isolated coastal showers, especially just to the south and east of Orlando, but otherwise looking mostly sunny with high temperatures below, going back to average. So we transition from slightly cooler back to average conditions as we head into Sunday. So we're gonna be warming up into the mid 70s across the entire viewing area. So that's a little bit better. So if you're still like 70s as far as average temperatures go, then I think it'll be a good day to be outdoors just as well, like Saturday. So if you plan on going out to the attractions or going to the beach or maybe going out shopping as we get into the second half of the holiday weekend, once again, just enjoy the weather, at least dry weather, and of course the warm temperatures and the slightly cooler temperatures if you can. Right, now into the President's Day holiday, which is next Monday the 17th. It looks like we'll be looking dry for Central Florida. Again, cannot rule out a couple of isolated showers here down in Brevard and Osceola counties, but otherwise looking dry with mostly sunny weather here in the viewing area. So if you got big plans going on your day off of work and school, it looks like you should be good to go also. And as we look at these high temperatures below, we'll be a little bit more cooler again. So just keep that in mind. But at least we'll still be closer to average. We're talking about mostly lower to perhaps even mid 70s as we head into President's Day. So looking again, pretty nice weather as we head into the holiday. All right, the day after President's Day, as you folks head back to work and kids head back to school, which is next Tuesday, a week from today, it looks like we'll see again mostly dry conditions with mostly sunny skies. But notice here on the GFS, still just want to print out maybe a few isolated coastal showers here over towards the I-95 corridor from Brevard into Volusia counties. But nothing too major to worry about as we head into a week from today as far as the weather goes, which is good. And as we look at these high temperatures below, we'll be warming up again. Not a big warm up, but just a warm up. I'm talking too fast here. A warm up to average temperatures as we head into that day. We're talking about mostly mid 70s. We're talking about for highs as we head into next Tuesday. So looking good there. All right, taking you to a week from tomorrow. This is next Wednesday, February the 19th. It looks like we'll see yet again another day of mostly dry weather with plenty of sunshine, but it could be a few isolated coastal showers possible if you live along the coast of Brevard County, but otherwise looking pretty good. But notice here on the GFS, we may be tracking yet another system. This could be potential of system number two that could try to make its way towards Florida, not on Wednesday of next week, but maybe the day after. We'll have to look at next Thursday's forecast here in just a second to see what it says. But It could be possible, but we'll wait and see. But we're still about a week away, and you may never know, that could change once we get closer. But for now, we'll be dry again as we head into a week from tomorrow. And as we look at these high temperatures, and ahead of the second cold front we'll be tracking potentially, we'll still be warmer with highs only in the mid to upper 70s to lower 80s. So we're going to call for 70s to lower 80s again as we head into the middle of next week. So there you have it. And getting to next Thursday, February the 20th, it looks like almost all of us should be looking dry here in Central Florida with mostly sunny skies. But again, if you live in Osceola or Brevard counties, a couple of coastal showers cannot be ruled out. But we'll watch them carefully, but otherwise nothing big is to worry about. But it looks like the cold front could make its way closer to our viewing area as we head into next Thursday. We'll have to watch the models carefully because, again, we're still about a week off, so that could still, really change as we get closer. And as we look at these high temperatures down below, yep, here comes the second cold front here as we get into next Thursday. So that's going to drop temperatures from the 70s down into the 60s for most of the entire viewing area. So that's going to bring the transition from warm to cool, if that's correct, as we head into that day. But notice here on the GFS, though, basically up here across parts of Volusia and Flagler counties, notice temperatures could dip down into the upper 50s for highs as we head into that day. But again, this is land of voodoo, so that could still really change here, guys, as we get closer. So just please keep that on note. All right, now heading into next Friday, February the 21st, it looks like we'll see yet again, like I've been saying several times here, like we're going to see maybe for several days next week, but for next Friday, could be a few isolated coastal showers. Again, right along the I-95 corridor from Flagler to Volusia and Brevard counties. Could be some right here across parts of Eastern Orange and Osceola counties as well, but otherwise looking mostly sunny, including here in Orlando as we head into next Friday as well. So that's something we'll watch, but again, you just may never know, that could still change as we get closer. And looking at these high temperatures, yes, we'll still be cooler, with temperatures in the mid to upper 60s to maybe about 70, especially south of Orlando as we head into that day. So yeah, that's something we'll watch, but again, you just may never know, that could change as we get closer. So just keep on checking back here for the rest of this week for any changes to the models as we get into the next couple of weeks as we get into late February. All right, now heading into the real pure land of voodoo country. This is for Saturday, February the 22nd. That's going to be the last Saturday for, I believe. Actually, no, it's not the last Saturday of February. That's the 29th. So sorry, I got my days mixed up. So, but still, this is Saturday the 22nd here. This is a week from this Saturday, so it's not the last Saturday for the month, not quite yet. But it does show, though, there could be a few isolated showers that could continue again from I-4 and east, especially from Sanford into Orlando, over towards the coastal areas of Brevard and Volusia counties, but otherwise not a big rainmaker to worry about. But the rest of our viewing area should be looking pretty dry with maybe some sunshine, if that is correct. And as we look at these high temperatures down below, we'll still be slightly cooler, as always, with highs only in the mid to upper 60s to about 70. So, again, we'll see what happens, because again, we're getting into the land of voodoo country, so that could really change as we get closer, like I've been saying before many times. All right, now let's get into Sunday the 23rd. It looks like the coastal shower event will be moving out of there and or out of here rather, and push off towards the Atlantic into the Caribbean. So that'll give us some plenty of dry weather for Central Florida with lots of sunshine as we get into the final Sunday for the month. And as we look at these high temperatures, as always below, still cooler. So it looks like we'll remain on the cooler side as we head into the long weekend. Well, it's not going to be a holiday, but I meant to say like a long weekend, which is Thursday and Friday of next week, and then to Saturday and Sunday. So that's what I meant to say, in case if you guys are just confused. So it's not a holiday, so just keep that in mind. But it's still going to be cooler though as we head into that day with highs only in the low to mid 60s. So yeah, could be really a cooler end maybe potentially as we head into late February. So that's something we could watch. But again, it's too early to tell if this will happen, but you just may never know, guys. It could really change as we get closer. All right, taking you to 2 weeks from yesterday. This is for Monday the 24th. That's the last Monday for this month. It looks like we'll see another day of dry weather with lots of sunshine across central Florida. So looking clear, not just here in Florida, but across much of the interior southeastern United States too. And the high temperatures below, again, still cooler with mid to upper 60s to about 70 across central Florida. So it looks like the cooler temps could continue as we head into the final week of this month. So we'll see. Right, now let's get into 2 weeks from today. This is on Tuesday, February the 25th. It looks like we'll see yet again another day of dry weather with lots of sunshine in central Florida. And high temperatures below for the 25th will be, again, still cooler, but looks like we'll be warming up just a little bit, but not a big warm up. So we'll still remain in the upper 60s into the lower 70s, we're going to say for now, as we head into the following week from today, if this is correct here. But again, this is Land of Voodoo, so that could still, change as we get closer. So as always, just keep on checking back for any changes as we get, again, closer to the following week, which is the last week of February. All right, taking you to 2 weeks from tomorrow. This is for Wednesday, February the 26th. It looks like we'll see yet again another dry day in central Florida. More sunshine, but notice here back over towards the west of our state, there could be a potential of maybe a third storm system that could try to bring maybe some rain across parts of the Mississippi Valley region. It looks like this could be heading into our direction, but again, too early to tell if this will happen, but you just may never know. It could still change as we get closer. High temperatures below. We'll start to warm up back into the lower to perhaps even mid-70s, so getting back to average as we head into the 26th, or the 26th rather. But again, like I've said before, Land of Voodoo, and it will change as we get closer. But ahead of that, there could be that could be ahead of a third cold front that could drop or that could drop temperatures behind it, especially in the Mississippi Valley region into the 40s and 50s. So again, something to watch, but it will change. All right, let's get into actually, this is my birthday, the 27th. So yes, the 27th is my birthday, and that's where we're going to end our video for tonight. And the forecast shows on my special day, the following Thursday looks to be almost all of us looking dry. But notice here on the GFS, it looks like that third system could get closer to us, and that could bring maybe a very higher rain coverage across parts of the Florida Panhandle, including the northern sections of the peninsula, into parts of the Mississippi Valley region. So that is something we'll have to watch. But notice here on the GFS, there could be a few isolated coastal showers ahead of that third system on my special day. Again, that's my birthday. So something to watch. But again, it's this Land of Voodoo, so that could still change as we get closer and as we look at these high temperatures below. And once before the third front gets closer, we'll see temperatures ahead of that remain average with highs only in the low to mid 70s. So again, it's too early to tell if this will happen because we're 2 weeks away. So just keep on checking back for any additional changes as we get closer to the final full work week of February. So there you go. All right, guys, I'm going to start wrapping up this feed here on this Tuesday evening. So that's it for the forecast video update. And I hope to be back here first thing early tomorrow morning for the next edition between 7 or 7:30. Yes, I'll be up early in the morning because I'll have plans going on during the day tomorrow. So just keep that in mind. So if you could join us for the next edition by then. And I'll continue as always by posting more notes or updates on my blog and Facebook pages 24/7. But in the meantime, hope you guys enjoy the rest of your Tuesday evening. And I'll see you guys in the morning. All right, you guys take care and God bless.